one. Okay, so it's... Wait, is this... Anybody? Nobody. Okay. It's Ted Udetsky. You know, I'm coming to London to do Deconstructing Broadway at the Leicester Square Theatre on Sunday, August 10th, and I'm answering these questions for the public reviews that were sent to me across the pond, as we say. Okay, you were a writer for American star Rosie O'Donnell for a couple of years. Were there any particular challenges associated with that? Yeah, it was a live show, and she went on the air at 10 a.m. in the morning, and she had had material before 10 a.m. in the morning, so we had to be at work. Well, basically, we had to pitch our jokes for her by 7:30 a.m. So we had to write the jokes before 7:30. I play piano on Broadway, so I'd be playing like ragtime on Broadway. By the way, what actual piano piece goes like this in opposing scales? None. The point is, I'd be playing ragtime on Broadway till like 11 o'clock at night, crazy exhausted, you know, get home, wake up the next morning at 6. Anyway, the challenge was incredible tiredness and bags under the eyes. Thank you. Love, Seth. How do you know if something you've written is funny? You know what? I'm the king of like nonstop calling my friends and like being like, is this, like reading them jokes. Is this funny? Is this funny? Is this funny? So I think it's basically asking my friends. I mean, the only way you really know is in performance, but I'm constantly asking people. And, you know, even when I've written my books, I've called my really good friend Anika Larson, my really close friend Jack Plotnick, my husband James. I'm always like reading chapters of my books to people to see if they're funny. So I basically have to have feedback to know that it's funny. I'm needy. Do you think it was a good decision to become a TV writer? Yeah. It taught me to write under pressure. It taught me how to punch up. You know, when you write something and then maybe it's not up to snuff, so you punch it up. And it made me feel like a real writer because we got nominated for, you know, we got nominated for some Emmy Awards. So I felt like, oh, I'm actually a writer. And I think maybe if I hadn't done that, I don't know if I would have written my books. Because I felt, you know, before then I was like a piano player who was funny, but when I got an actual job and got paid to be a writer, I was like, I guess I'm a writer. So I don't regret it at all. What should we expect from Deconstructing Broadway? Oh, that's my show. Deconstructing Broadway is a show that I do. It's basically a comedy show. My hair looks crazy. It's basically a comedy show, but where I, wait, it looks crazier? Where I, oh, don't look at the lace front. Where I show videos and I play audio that I'm obsessed with and I analyze what I think is amazing about it or bizarre about it. I'll give you one example. This is Cheetah Rivera in Chicago. It's so amazing. You know, people think of her as just a dancer, but she's an amazing singer. And in this is the end of All That Jazz. This is the reprise of All That Jazz. She's sort of feigned. She has vocal damage. You know, like it's the 20s and, you know, she's been drinking gin and smoking cigarettes and I got nothing left, nothing. But then I'm always like, I guess in the recording studio, maybe she had like a drink of water because suddenly on the last note, it's a D in the mask with amazing vibrato. So it's like vocal damage, nodes, stress, clear as a bell vibrato. It is so brilliant. So this is a quick deconstruction for you. Okay, here we go. Here we go. Is this playing? You get the phlegm? But then suddenly... amazing. Okay, so many things on my screen I have to control. Okay, here we go. Elaine Page is the self-styled queen of British musical theater, justified or not? Yes, it's justified. She created, like, all these iconic roles. She was the first. Wait, do I have... Okay, she was the first to belt this. Come on, people. She was the first. She was the first... My God, this crazy note she had to hit in the Chess concept album, if you heard this, out of nowhere. She has to hit, like, I think it's like an E-flat. Hold on, let me find it. It's crazy. Okay. It's just out of nowhere she has to hit it. Get ready. Maybe he's scared, just as scared as he was in the game. Suddenly. Come on. So yeah, she's the queen of musical theater. Bravo to her. You're bringing your 2013 musical Disaster back next year. Any particular reason why so soon? Okay, so if you don't know, Disaster is it's like a 1970s disaster movie, but as a musical, and it has all the disasters from all those movies. It's like, you know, a tidal wave and piranhas and earthquake and fire. We're not really bringing it back. We're bringing it to the next level. We ran off Broadway. We got really amazing reviews, and now we have a Broadway producer, and we're going to Broadway. So we ain't bringing it back. We're moving on up. That's the theme song to the Jeffersons, the American TV show. Anybody? So anyway, yeah, we're coming to Broadway, and I really hope it's the West End. To me, it's such a show that would be amazing, the West End, because it's all music from the 70s. Like, all your favorite Donna Summer. I mean, it's the best music, and it's also hilarious. So anyway, we're going to Broadway, and hopefully the West End. Do you consider yourself primarily a writer, musician, or actor? You know, I think it's like those dancers that say I'm a dancer first. I'm a musician first. I began taking piano lessons when I was 5, so I'll always be, I feel, everything is from a musical perspective, but I consider myself, it sounds crazy, but an entertainer. That's what I feel. I love the entertainment field. I love writing and performing, and I just love everything. So I consider myself an entertainer first. It sounds sort of like a bad Vegas showgirl, but no, that's what I think of myself as, entertainer. What am I looking at? Oh, what was it like growing up gay and Jewish in a tough neighborhood like Jamaica, Queens? It probably was really hard for whoever did it. I was born in Jamaica, Queens, and I lived there for 4 years, and I guess I was gay and Jewish back in those days, but I was only 4 years old, so I don't know how, quote unquote, obvious it was. And then we got the hell out. So I had 4 years in Jamaica, Queens, and then we moved to Long Island, which was, it was not quite as tough. Everyone's parent was basically a doctor. So yeah. It actually was hard in other ways. It was sort of horrific in its own way, but I certainly wasn't like scared of, you know, I don't know, street thugs. What's the last thing? Any periods in your life you regret? I sort of regret in my 20s, kind of nobody telling me that it's okay to not be successful. I guess I felt, I don't know, I just felt, oh my God, I've been here so long. Why am I not on Broadway? And I've been in New York for like a year. So I just regret constantly being like, what's taking so long? I'm a loser. I'm a failure. Instead of like everybody, nobody, I mean, very few people become really successful in their early 20s. I think it's like Barbara Streisand, Jonathan Groff, but it's just not that common. So I regret that I thought I was such a failure for those early years in my 20s before I actually got to Broadway. My first Broadway show, I think I was 25, but it felt like I'd been in New York forever. You played Arnold in Schwarzenegger Trilogy, which is kind of an iconic dream role. Are there any other roles you have your eye on? I really want to play, like in a full production, Vernon, and they're playing our song. I did it once with Sutton Foster for A Night. You can find the clips online, but I'd love to do a run of it because he's a musician. He's really funny. It's just, I get to play the piano. I would love, love, love to do that. I'd also love to do a show, A Day in Hollywood, A Night in Ukraine, which there was a Brit that wrote that show, Frank Lazarus. So I'd love to do A Day in Hollywood, Not in Ukraine, and they're playing our song, and of course, Disaster. If you were stranded on a desert island, what three items did you take with you? Oh my God, my dogs, my family, and anything musical? Something musical. I have to have music around. Actually, I was just obsessing, I'll play this. I was just obsessing about Lilias White. Do I have it here? In How to Succeed in Business. This is the kind of thing, like I have to listen to this all the time. Okay, wait, I have to actually find it. I think it's called Sony. Sorry, people online that are bored right now. Sony. Oh, what the hell is it? Okay, hold on. We're going to edit this out, even though I don't really know how to edit. So I'm going to. Oh, man. I love Lilias White. Can I just play this for you? Don't go anywhere, please. Oh, maybe this. Here. This is Lilias White. Yeah. Okay. She sounds amazing on this. Listen to this. Oh, just such breath. This. Keep listening. She goes up. It's so scary. So good. In conclusion, I like music. Come see my show, Leicester Square Theater. What's it called? Deconstructing from Broadway, Sunday, August 10th. Peace to the out. By the way, I'm literally sweating from my own interview. I made myself nervous.